Mukesh Thakur, Inequality for All. Inequality for All, Mukesh Thakur.
Thank you. How many of you want equalization for women? Now let me prove you that you don't. Dear Toastmaster of the day, ladies and gentlemen, can you describe this picture in one word?
My life.
This is funny, right? Now can you describe this picture in one word?
Brutal. Inhuman.
Now let's stop for a moment and think. If we are promoting equality, how come the first picture gave us a funny impression, but the second picture not so funny impression? Recently I read an article where wife collects all wife beating husbands and husbands beating wife jokes. They found wife beating husbands was funny, wife beating husbands with villain was funny, husbands beating wife with something manly was not funny. Wife bossing husbands was funny, but husbands bossing wife was not funny. Husbands crawling away and wife wasting money on trinket was funny, but wife crawling away and husband wasting money on alcohol wasn't funny. Husband making wife making husbands wash utensils with a squash bag was funny, but husband making wife wash utensils with a squash bag was not funny. If we are ambassadors for the equality, how come the first part of the joke appears to be funny, but not second part? Because the second part is truth, and we don't laugh on truth. We feel joy and content by putting our thought process on respecting women, because we already know that women are not equal, and we have a glorifying feel that people will respect us for having those thoughts. By promoting equality, we have already acknowledged inequality. A rape by a boy is called inhuman, but a rape by a girl is a matter of fun at police station. Because we already know that only a boy is strong enough to do that. Dear so-called ladies and gentlemen, let's assume, let's acknowledge that it is already set in our subconscious mind that women are not equal. That's why our conscious mind tries to equalize them. I don't know when it started, because as far as I know, that humanity was started with one man and one woman who were equal. Let's also check this fact with so-called highly educated platforms. As per the research done by Dana Kenzin, although 38% of the US companies were founded by women, they got only 2% of the venture capitalist fundings. She went into the deep and found it was because there was difference between the questions asked from the male startups and the female startups. While the male startups were asked the promotion question, the female startups were asked the prevention question. Promotion question means growth, while prevention question means survival. And there was no difference between the questions asked by male venture capitalists or the female venture capitalist. TED Talk speaker Stacy Smith conducted a study. She interviewed dozens of film industry insiders and asked them about directors. Turns out, both male and female executives, when they think directors, they think male. They perceive the traits of leadership to be masculine in nature. So when they are going to hire a director or command a crew, leadership or be a visionary or be general pattern, all the things that we have heard, their thought and attention pull male. The perception of a director or a leader is inconsistent with the perception of a woman. The roles are incongruous, which is consistent with a lot of research in the psychological arena. Dear ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, let's dig our thought process. If we really want to reap the benefits of equality, and let's also understand that by bringing equality, we are not giving any obligation to them. Rather, we are lacking half of our strength. While males are putting their efforts for the growth of the humanity, most of the women's strength are wasting in just proving themselves. It is time to realize if we want only women empowerment or we want their hands with us. Let's check if we are ready for this. If you don't question why only females change their surnames after marriage, you are not ready. If you don't question why only female leave their family after marriage, you are not ready. If you are not surprised by watching commercials with female featuring for household items and males for luxury cars, you are not ready. If housewives is more familiar word to you than house husband, you are not ready. So dear equal human, let's gear up and introspect to leverage the lesser utilized half population of our strength. Let's introspect and grow together, which is faster, better, and happier. That's my story.